Sarah, what happened?
Someone was in here.
What?
I don't know. I didn't see anyone. I could feel someone pushing me underwater.
You're safe now. Let's get you out of here.
Sarah was attacked last night?
She told Connor she felt someone pushing her under the water.
I can't believe they're actually doing this. Why start now?
The real question is, why Sarah?
Because they're crazy?
Yeah, but why start once Beck and Rachel disappear? What if they had something to do with it?
How could they? They're not even inside the gate.
Doesn't mean they're not working from the outside.
Zoe, do you hear yourself right now? Pretty sure that's not possible. And even if it was, I doubt they're smart enough to do it.
Maybe that's what's wrong. Look, we can't keep underestimating people. Maybe that's the reason we're always one step behind. We trust too many people. Do you think that it's possible?
What?
That someone we're close with is the reason all of this is happening.
You can't think like that. This is what they want from us. They want us to turn on each other.
I hear you, but...
But what? Zoe, I can't picture that because I don't believe it.
We have to do something about this.
What are we gonna do? I don't wanna watch the cameras 24/7.
Well, maybe you should, because a lot of stuff has been happening lately.
Not my fault. And I refuse to sit in front of those screens all day again. I haven't touched them since I found them.
Maybe they know you found them.
It's possible, but I left everything the way I found it. I didn't go through the file.
What files?
I found files hidden in the folder when I accessed the cameras.
And you haven't gone through them? Are you stupid?
If I open the files, they'll know, and everything will shut down.
We'll figure out a way around them.
Well, how about you do it? Don't push this onto me to make it seem like it's all my fault.
Hello? Hello? I understand.
Okay, I know I snapped earlier, but we have a problem. I can't find Sarah.
What do you mean you can't find her?
I mean, she's not on campus. She left without us.
What is up with people going places on their own?
She left at 5 this morning.
Are you kidding me?
No, so get ready. We have to find her before someone else does.
Shouldn't you be with Sarah?
Yeah, but we need to find out who attacked her.
Well, you leaving her all alone makes her an easy target. When's the last time you've seen her?
Last night? Why?
Well, we have a problem. She left campus early this morning.
Are you crazy? You could have been kidnapped.
I'm sorry, I just couldn't stay there. I had to leave.
So you come to the mall?
I figured I'd get an early start. I found my dress, and I found dresses for the both of you in that new store over there, the one Becca went in.
Okay, well, let's go look at them.
Actually, I got a hotel room, and I'm pretty tired, so I'm gonna go rest.
It'll take 5 minutes for me to try on the dress, and then we all can go together, okay?
Fine.
Could you drive any slower?
I'm going the speed limit.
The speed limit's 30. There's no one on this road. You can go faster.
I think I'll stick to the speed limit.
Screw the speed limit. If you don't go faster, I'm gonna kick your ass.
When we crash and we all die, it'll be your fault.
So, how many dresses do you have in there?
Two and a big box.
Alright, well, I'm gonna go find a dress that's not yellow.
Okay.
Why are we at the mall?
Girls love the mall.
Do you have a yellow fetish or something?
No. I just look good in yellow.
It's actually not your color.
But it's unique.
Oh my gosh, Zoe, what happened?
I don't want to talk.
Busted. I only see two of you. Where's Sarah?
She's tired, so she found a hotel.
Well, we have two cars, so I'll take one and go get her.
Actually, she has a car, so it's better if we all go.
We'll drop them off and meet back later.
Well, I'll take one of the cars that's here.
Guys, it's getting dark. Should we really be splitting up?
Well, I'll be back in no time.
Tony, what are you doing here? You have to leave.
Becca, get in the car.
No, listen to me. You have to go now, Tony, please.
Becca, I sent the text.
What?
It was me. Get in. So, what does a world without Maxwell look like?
Well, it turns out Maxwell isn't the only thing trying to kill us. Everyone else is too. Are you mad at me for leaving and not telling you?
Zoe, get over here. All I want you to know is that you're never alone. Not even for a second. Becca, look at me. Like, I know you're scared, but they can't find us out here.
I'm not scared.
Okay, good.
I'm terrified! You think you know what's going on, but you don't.
You showing up at the coffee shop proves that I do.
Oh, right. So you figured out there's someone else out there. Tony, you don't even know what that means.
It means that you can stop lying to me. You can stop running. Becca!
Look, it's not that easy, Tony. Look, these people kill and they hunt. They hurt whoever they want. These people...
What, Becca?
They want me dead. I wouldn't hurt you. And they think I'm working for them and that I'm becoming distracted. That's why I ran. I wanted to stay, but I couldn't. You think I'd just walk away if I had the choice?
What about the files?
Tony.
I mean, if we could figure out what they mean, we can figure out who's after you.
I'm not going down this road with you.
Becca, this could be anyone. A friend. Are you prepared for that?
Tony, this isn't easy for me either. All right? I miss you so much because you're the only one that cared.
Becca, I still care. You know what? For the record, I am going to help you figure this out. And I'm not asking for your permission.
I'm surprised it took you so long. But you found me.
I can't help it.
Why don't you let people see the good in you?
Because when people see good, they expect good. And I don't want to live up to anyone's expectations. Why not? Sarah.
I don't blame you for leaving to look for her. But you should have told me. You can't leave on your own.
Why not?
It was childish and stupid. I thought something would have happened to you. Next time. You aren't allowed to leave without my permission.
You really are a jerk, Garrett. You can't just go around deciding things for me. You don't get to call me childish and stupid for protecting a friend. I've always been honest with you. I don't deserve to be treated like a child.
I was wrong. Forgive me.
No.
Forgive me.
Guys, we need to go. Hunter's found us again.
All right, well, this time I'll drive.
Would you like help carrying everything upstairs?
No, I'll just put it away later.
You sure? I don't mind.
How about a soda?
Sure. So, next time you see Tony, you should totally wear your new lacy underwear.
Good idea.
So, what did you tell him?
Um,
I just told him everything you said I should tell him.
Nothing more.
Nothing more.